be available to watch later, won't it, Todd? It will be available to watch later?
Yep.
Yeah.
Yep.
I was hoping that. We're not keeping masks on during the program. You don't need to.
Well, alrighty then.
You run home and get it?
No, I was looking for, there's a song in the air.
Yeah, I've got it here.
Do you? Well, bless your heart.
What's that?
It's me.
Oh, probably, everybody better turn their phones off too.
There you go.
Alright.
Is that the one that wasn't in the handbook?
Yeah. One of those calls from who knows where.
I think I had 50 of those calls.
They slowed way down.
Yeah.
I think I've only had like two or three today.
I know. Ken's been getting them on his, but not because he got any online. I was knocking on his.
Come in on the table.
I guess we could.
No.
Well, do we let, should we have Marv just kind of play a little something?
A little something?
Are we ready to roll?
It's gone, it's rolling.
To welcome all of you here tonight, all of you that are out in our Ebenezer land that will want to watch, hopefully want to watch our special event program for tonight. And we hope that you'll be blessed as we sing some carols, we have devotions, and a few other special activities that we've prepared for you. I read an article just the other day stating that Christmas would be canceled this year. There would not be any nativity this year because the three wise men face a travel ban. The shepherds have been furloughed, and the innkeeper, his business is kind of down. Santa won't be working either, as he would break the rule of six with Dasher, Prancer, Dancer, Vixen, Donner, and Blitzen. As for Rudolph, with that red nose, he should be isolating or taking the COVID test. Now, we can't let that happen here. No way. Christmas will not be canceled. Maybe we won't have Christmas quite the same as what we usually do, but that might give us more time to prepare for what Christmas is really all about, the birth of Jesus. So sit down and relax. Remember the reason for the season and enjoy the evening with us. We're pleased to have Barb with us tonight, Barb Nunnekoven, and she'll be playing for the carols that we sing and giving us a lot of good Christmas music. So now we'll have our devotions called The Christmas Candle.
As we sing our song, Christmas carols and light our candles to shed a cheery greeting across a wintry way, we feel the spirit of Christmas once again reaching us in its magic embrace. But in all this melody and light, may we hear and see above all that Christ is Christmas.
Thank you.
Matthew 1, verses 21 and 22. She will give birth to a son, and you are to give him the name Jesus, because he will save his people from their sins. All this took place to fulfill what the Lord had said through the prophet. The virgin will conceive and give birth to a son, and they will call him Emmanuel, which means God with us. And then from Luke 1, verses 6 and 7. While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn son. She wrapped him in clothes and placed him in a manger, because there was no guest room available for them.
Than the song to say, Ferris Lord Jesus.
I don't know what that was.
Just tell them. Tell them we're going to sing Ferris Lord Jesus.
We're going to sing Ferris Lord Jesus. Is for the heavenly choir that told of the birth of God's Son. Luke 2, 12 and 13. Suddenly, a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to men on whom his favor rests." We'll now do the first verse of "It Came Upon a Midnight Clear."
For a Redeemer, God sent his Son that he might redeem us from our sin. From Galatians 4, 4 and 5. But when the time had fully come, God sent his Son, born of a woman, born under law, to redeem those under law, that we might receive the full rights of sons. Please join us in singing the first verse of Silent Night. Thank you.
I is for an inn so crowded that there is no room for the heavenly visitor. The inn with all its man-made splendor could not compare with the glow found in the lowly manger where the Christ child lay. Even so, we may make room in our heart to receive the King of Glory. I'm going to read from Luke chapter 2, verse 7. And she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger because there is no guest room available for them. And now we will be singing. There's a song in there.
S is for the shepherds. Most humble men, they waited in faith for the promised Messiah. And to these humble shepherds came the heavenly messengers themselves with the good tidings of the birth of Christ. I'll be reading from Luke 2, verses 8, 9, 10, and 11. And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them. And they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good tidings of great joy that will be for all the people. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is Christ the Lord." Let us sing the first verse of "While Shepherds Watch Their Flocks."
He is for the wise man who followed the star to find the Christ child. May we, like the Magi of old, find our way to the Christ child and lay our gifts at his feet. I'll be reading from Matthew chapter 2, verses 1, 2, 8, 9, 10, and 11. After Jesus was born in Bethlehem in Judea, during the time of King Herod, Magi from the east came to Jerusalem and asked, "Where is the one who has been born King of the Jews? We saw his star when it rose and have come to worship him. But you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, and by no means least among the rulers of Judah, for out of you will come a ruler who will shepherd my people Israel." Then Herod called the Magi secretly and found out from them the exact time the star had appeared. He sent them to Bethlehem and said, "Go and search carefully for the child. As soon as you find him, report to me, so that I too may go and worship him." After they had heard the king, they went on their way, and the star that they had seen when it rose went ahead of them until it stopped over the place where the child was. One more. On coming into the house, they saw the child with his mother Mary, and they bowed down and worshipped him. Then they opened their treasures and presented him with gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh.
Thank you. tonight we're going to do a little Christmas quiz. I have about 10 questions for you, and true or false? Let's see how we do. True or false? Joseph and Mary went from Nazareth to Bethlehem. It is true. Luke 2, verse 4. So Joseph also went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and the line of David. Question 2. True or false? When Joseph and Mary traveled, Mary rode a donkey, but Joseph walked.
No, false.
It is false. Although possible because of Mary's condition, this isn't mentioned in the Bible. Number 3, true or false? Straw filled the manger where Jesus lay.
Maybe.
This is false. The Bible doesn't mention any straw. Number 4, true or false? Jesus was born in a cold winter's night. It is false. You'll find this in the opening stanza of the first Noel, but is not in the Bible. Number 5, true or false? The shepherds were terrified when an angel of the Lord appeared to them, announcing Christ's birth. It is true. In Luke 2:9, and an angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were filled with great fear. All right, number 6, true or false? The Magi were from the east.
True.
It is true. Matthew 2:1, after Jesus was born in Bethlehem in Judea, during the time of King Herod, Magi from the east came to Jerusalem. Number 7, true or false? King Herod sent the Magi to Bethlehem. That is true. Matthew 2:8, he sent them to Bethlehem and said, "Go and search carefully for the child. As soon as you find him, report to me so that I too may go and worship him." All right, number 8, true or false? 3 Magi visited Bethlehem.
False. Don't know.
It is false. When you sing the first Noel or We Three Kings, remember the account doesn't say how many. Matthew 2:11 says gifts of gold, incense, and myrrh were presented, but 3 gifts doesn't mean 3 kings. Number 9, true or false? The Magi came to a house where the child and his mother were. Yes, it is true. Matthew 2:11. On coming to the house, they saw the child with his mother Mary, and they bowed down and worshiped him. Then they opened their treasures and presented him with gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And notice his present isn't mentioned. Last one, true or false? After finding the child, the Magi were warned not to go back to Herod.
True.
It is true. Matthew 2:12, and having been warned in a dream not to go back to Herod, they returned to their country by another route. So how did you do? Well, if you had 9 to 10 correct, go tell it on the mountain. You're an Advent expert. If you have 8 to 9 correct, ring the bells. Let the whole world know you can stand on your own in the category of Christmas trivia. If you had 7 to 8, what child is this? Are you sure you know? And 6 to 7, correct. Joy to the world. A makeup quiz will be given later. Be there. And if you had 5 or less, add a Bible commentary to your Christmas list.
Thank you.
don't know about at your house, but when we're waiting for a birthday to happen, one thing we have to do is always think about a cake. So, and since we're talking about tonight, about the getting ready for the birth of Jesus, I think we have a cake, but somebody's already gotten into it, haven't they? Well, now's your time to go get your snack if you want a piece of cake or whatever you have. But we've got more music.
Thank you. to do this evening, and it comes from the time when Shirley Temple was a leading child actress during the Great Depression. So I'm sure that some of the audience remember Shirley Temple, and some of the audience is way too young to maybe remember Shirley Temple. But this is a true story that took place during the time of the Depression. Little Estelle Mary Kent had her heart set on asking Santa for a Shirley Temple doll for Christmas. She was 8 years old and knew they were poor like everyone else was, but didn't begin to realize how poor they really were. Her father had been ill for quite some time and was unable to work. So her mother sat at the treadle sewing machine all day, every day, and into the night. Her mother would sew anything for anyone. But Estelle hadn't known it was to keep the wolf from the door, so to speak, to pay for the fuel, the rent on their tiny house, for food and for medicine for Dad. As December unfolded ever so slowly for little Estelle, she kept mentioning her doll more all the time, dreaming of her coming to be a part of their family. Times were hard, and her mother tried gently to explain that there would be a tree they would trim together, and there would be a gift she planned to make while Estelle was in school, and she told her they would bake cookies together. Christmas would be nice, she assured her little girl, and they would be together, the three of them. But the doll might have to wait for another Christmas or another time. All the while, her ill husband kept hearing about the dream and Christmas. Knowing that the nickels and dimes his wife earned sewing would not stretch to include a doll for his little Shelley, it would be his last Christmas, he knew, and even if there had been work for him, he would not have been able to do it. He knew he had to sell something to get the money for the doll. He thought of the only thing of worth that he possessed. It was a gold watch. It had been handed down from his grandfather to his father, and now it was his. He would have to try to find a buyer for it. This time of year, with money short for everyone, he couldn't think of anyone he could call. Finally, he did call the store and asked to speak to the owner. Did he have any Shirley Temple dolls left? And yes, the merchant said, he thought he had one or two in stock. If one was still there, he could have it put aside for him, provided that he would come in and pick it up. The ill father said he had a problem coming up with the funds. But would the merchant consider trading his gold heirloom watch for the doll? It was very important, he explained. The merchant hesitated a few moments and asked him to bring it down. He had to share the plan with his wife, and she immediately agreed the doll was more important to this Christmas than the watch would ever be when little Estelle grew up. Little Estelle could think of nothing else but Christmas and the doll she knew Santa would bring her. She had prayed about it often in her private way, and she had plans. The Shirley Temple doll would sleep in her bed, and she would never leave her home alone. She knew in her heart that the doll would be there at Christmas, never once realizing what her parents were going through. All too early Christmas morning, she crept downstairs on tiptoe, peeking around the door. There was the doll, sitting straight up in Estelle's old wood rocker, which had belonged to her mother before her. She slowly tiptoed closer and touched her hand. It was soft, and her dress was robin-egg blue with lace. Her golden curls were shiny, and her head was full of hair, lots of it. She was more beautiful than she had imagined she'd be. She picked her up gently and found she had soft arms and legs, and she wore shoes, little black slippers with ties and bobby socks. She examined her dress and found she was even wearing underwear. She hadn't wanted to wake or disturb her parents, but this excitement was way too much to handle alone. She tiptoed back upstairs and stood there, watching her father sleep. It wasn't often that she saw him sleeping, for he had a problem with sleeping. So she quietly stood there watching him breathe with her eyes on his face until he stirred. When he saw her, at first he stared, and then his face broke into the happiest smile she had ever seen on him. 1 month later, her father died. Time passed, and a day came when Estelle and her mother together went through his personal things. Estelle was looking for his gold watch, which she knew he had valued. It was hard for her mother to explain it all. It brought back memories of a very hard time, how together Estelle's parents had planned that Christmas to give their little girl a very last happy one with her father. So, just remember what God gave us, a little baby in the manger. So let's all be like Estelle and never leave him home. Take him everywhere we go.
I just want to thank everybody for taking part tonight. I hope that you have enjoyed the program that we had for you. Thank you also to Pastor Todd for being our filmer. I don't know if you call her producer or not, but anyway, the filming. And we hope that you've enjoyed it too. If you would join me in a word of prayer right now, and then we have one more song that we want to send you on your way with. So let's have a word of prayer first. Loving Father, help us to remember the birth of Jesus, that we may share in the song of the angels, the gladness of the shepherds, and the worship of the wise men. Close the door of hate and open the door of love all over the world. Let kindness come with every gift and good desires with every greeting. And may Christmas morning make us happy to be your children. And the Christmas evening bring us to our beds with grateful thoughts, forgiving and forgiven. And we just pray, Lord, that you would prepare our hearts for your coming. For you are the season, the reason for the season. We pray this all in Jesus' name. Amen. And now we're going to sing for you, or we're going to try to sing for you, Walking on Our Way to Bethlehem.